Hey everyone, it's me, Stagger. Because I decided that my life is going down a perilous spiral where I am trapped in an endless void to guide people so that way they won't feel the same pain I've been feeling for a very long time because this freaking area. Oh my gosh, I've been stuck on it for quite a while, and I mean, not as long as you might think it is. Comparing from my last mini walkthrough of this game, but honestly though, just, oh my gosh, like the freaking, you know, it's best if I show you how much pain I've been going through just for this one area. I actually had to look up the old Game FAQs guide to help me out, and even though it's poorly written, it was enough to help me through. But regardless, just, why did they think this was a good idea? I mean, I don't have any problems with mazes, but that enemy placement that they had, what the heck? As you can see here, I've been around the, my game time is currently at 20 minutes and 58 seconds with 61,025 Chiru, and freaking Rex is level 63. That's how long I've been actually stuck in that area. From a place with level 30s and 35s, yeah, it's not the prettiest thing in the world, but I am here to help you through all of this. This is the save that I had when I first went through the stupid little freaking bandit hideout. So yeah, to put that in perspective, I've been stuck in there for 10 in-game hours just trying to figure that whole place out. Anyway, so to save on time, I'm gonna be helping you out, and to save on time, I will be needing a punching bag. Luckily, I actually have one on my disposal. Remember this loser? Yep, we're gonna be calling this loser here. And he's gonna be our punching bag. I actually strongly do not recommend that you do a punching bag for this area here, because there is actually a lot of levels that you can gain as well as Chiru. So, with that being the case, don't be doing what I'm doing. I'm just doing this for the sake of time. And also, I would recommend, I will be avoiding items because, well, honestly, this video would be super long if I went through every single item. I would recommend, anyway, so if you, if you're not using a punching bag like I am, I would recommend that you actually have an aquatic Denjuu, an electric Denjuu, or a Denjuu that knows electric attacks, and whatever flying is weak against, which I can't honestly remember, but yeah, I would. But yeah, essentially though, as long as you have an electric Denjuu, a water Denjuu, and later on, well, and a powerful Denjuu, you should be okay. So, anyway, yeah, majority of the places, basically this entire place mostly does have sand Denjuu, or desert Denjuu. It also has flying Denjuu, as well as grassland, but those are very small compared to the amount of flying Denjuu there is as well. So overall, there is mostly desert Denjuu, flying Denjuu, mountain Denjuu, and then grassland Denjuu. And there's actually some Denjuu that is actually speed and power specific. However, these aren't actually Denjuu that you can see outside the map. These are only Denjuu that appear after, or, you know, if they're called into battle. These are uncommon to see and it's like a 50-50 chance, I think, that you get to see him. So anyway, items that you will be needing. Obviously, medical herbs. Herb pills. You will be needing herb pills. That is just the key rule when it comes to playing Telefang 2. Herb pills, some... That's antidote that cures poison, I think. Okay, I think this cures paralysis, I could be wrong. And then you're also going to be needing some... Okay, here we go. You're also going to be needing some alarm clocks. Alarm clocks are going to be very vital to your essential here. Anyway, so... Another thing is, it will help if you get some, if you have any DP cookies, DP 8s, or DP drinks. These are going to be pretty helpful, but you're not going to need too much, just enough that will help you out. Because there is actually going to be a boss fight near the end. So, anyway. This is after the bandit hideout. And after Midori joins your team, or sort of, she just follows you, or walks into you and just appears, and whatever. You put her in your pocket, and then, of course, you can talk to this T-Finger to obtain 10 herb pills for 800 Chiru. Since I'm pretty good with the amount of herb pills I have, it won't matter too much. And then you can also talk to this guy to heal up your Denjuu. However, since I'm using a punching bag, that won't be necessary. Anyway, so what we need to do is actually go to a new place, and it is just beyond this desert. So, or rather, this canyon. So, follow my instructions carefully, but not exactly. Now, the reason why I say that is because, well, you're going to be needing to... Actually, hold on, let me rephrase this. Yeah, follow my instructions carefully, but not exactly. Mainly because I haven't actually had this place memorized yet. So you go up this mound, all the way down to this bridge, and to the left. Now, we will be going down to the left, and down here. Now we go up. Oh, nope, that's a dead end. So we keep going down. Up this hill. To the right. Up. Oh, nope, a dead end, never mind. Down. To the... Okay, yeah, that's a dead end. So is that, so... Yeah, I went the wrong way. Sorry about that. So we go back down. Enraged. Try running away. Oh, did you see that? That was weird. Anyway. Go up here, avoid the cobra. There's a Penelope right there. Run away. Or battle, whatever. So yeah, we go up here. Try to avoid that humming. And now we want to get underneath this bridge. So we go down to the left and now up. Now we go to the left, or right, sorry. Oh! I completely forgot. Thank you for the tip. Anyway, I completely forgot. You want to turn off your animations. even if you're, you know, super hyped to go through this place, you just want to turn off your animations. Trust me on this, because... the freaking... because the freaking enemy placement here is just outright outrageous. So... yeah, you don't want to go there. You want to go all the way to the end. And we will actually be going into that cave later. But, anyway. So, you see grass. Let's walk towards that grass. Underneath this bridge. And we're here in another village. So, Yu is right here. Or Tome, if you're playing the speed version. Anyway, they're just asking us what we're doing here. We should be asking the same thing. Anyway, he's just walking away. And, yeah. So... now, what we need to do is go up to this little house up here and talk to this T-Finger. Now, they'll be talking a lot. Basically, there will be some explanation about the Atena Tree Seed being hidden within the ruins of this labyrinth. So, that's essentially what we're going to be going through. Anyway, so here we have a lab if you need to, basically reform, evolve, or even heal up. And then we also have a shop. So in case you're very low on herb pills, you can buy herb pills right here. They also sell antidotes, as well as DP-Aid, DP drink, and nuts. Nuts heal 80 HP, and DP-Aid heals 80 DP, or sorry, DP drink heals 88 DP, and then DP-Aid heals 50 DP. Antidote cures poison, and then this thing obviously heals 40 HP. I would recommend that you stock up, especially since, you know, you don't have a punching bag, so yeah. Anyway, now with that out of the way, Midori's just gonna be staying here. And now what we're gonna be going through is actually not that area that I pointed out, because we can't really get too far into it. So, there is actually a different entrance that we can go through, within, or, yeah, for this part. In fact, I'll go ahead and state that these have four different entrances, and that's why this cave is so annoying. None of the colors, well, actually, no, we'll get to that later. So, anyway, what we want to do is actually go through here, down, through, underneath this bridge. Trying to avoid the Penelope. And then underneath this bridge, through here, and we actually have a cave. All of these T-Fingers are able to heal your Denjuu. So, if you're really low on herbs for some reason, or you really don't have any money, or you're just grinding and don't want to spend any money, you can just use these guys to heal up your Denjuu. Anyway, so if we go in here, we get a call from Dad. Hola, papi, ¿qué pasa? No, seriously, though. Yeah, they're talking a lot. They're basically going to be talking about the ruins here and how there are four entrances and how each of the floors are color-coded. The color code that you want to go through is pink, brown, blue, and then green. That's actually the thing that they tell you. If you're playing the bootleg version, it will say something on the lines of... if I remember correctly, it was like pink, red, light blue, and then dark green. However, that red part is actually kind of misleading for sort of a brownish color. Actually, I think they do mention something about brown, but it's a little bit weird. But overall, all you need to know is that you want to go into pink, brown, blue, and then green. However, I'll go ahead and tell you that's not even the full story. Eventually, you will be wanting to be going into the brown room twice. So it's actually pink, brown, blue, brown, and then green. So, yeah, that's essentially what you need to do. So what we need to do right here now is actually go straight across. And now we go north, through the staircase, and here we have a puzzle. Now this puzzle is less intimidating than it looks. You just push this rock up, and then push this rock twice to the side. Oh, never mind. We push this down, and then we push this upper rock right here. So a door has opened up. Believe it or not, that door is actually just right up here. So now what we need to do is simply go down through these stairs, and then I believe it's the left side. Nope, that's a dead end. So now we go to the right side, we get caught, run away, and now we push this button. We are done with the pink room. So now we get out of here, we backtrack all the way out. And I'm gonna get caught. There's no escaping that. Okay. Now we go back out. Get out of here. Okay. Anyway, I would actually recommend that you pick up a few Denjuu from these caverns here. But like I said, since I'm guiding you guys through this, I'm not going to be doing so. Anyway, so now that we're done with the pink room, we need to go into the brown room, which is actually something we just saw not too long ago. So if we go down, backtrack all the way to this middle area here. Talk to this girl if you need a heal, and we are now entering into the brown room. Now, this is actually the biggest part of the dungeon in the entire, basically the biggest part of the dungeon. So, anyway, what we need to do here, what we need to do here is go up into this fork in the road, and we have to fight this guy. There's no avoiding him. So now we go up here, and now we go through these stairs. We go north. No, that's a dead end. So we go south, and then we go, I think, this way. Up. Right? Yeah, this looks familiar. Okay, that's a treasure chest. Here's a dead end. Waiting for that guy. And we got caught either way, so it didn't really matter. Okay, so we go through these stairs. And a dead end. Okay, my bad, but... Okay. So yeah, we weren't supposed to go there just yet then, if that's the case. What we need to do is continue going downward. Animation's on, right? Yeah, I should have them off. Okay. Now we go to here, and here we go. We have our first button. So now, that place we just went, we just entered and then exit, that's where we need to go. So. From that, and then now we go through here, up, wait for the Familio. Oh, okay, never mind, we have to fight both of them now, or really lose to both of them in my case. Okay, so yeah, back to that area we were just in earlier, and now we open this switch, which then opens a room area directly below us. So, now what we need to do is go back down. Gosh. And then we go down. Yeah, that's right. I think, nope, that's not it. Okay. So we need to go up then. And dead end. Dead end. So yeah, we just need to go back then right here. Then we go. Okay, there's a tress and dead end right there. That's a dead end over there. So we need to go here. Down these stairs. Up here. And then we go to the left. And we get another switch. Now we cannot do anything else around here. So what we need to do is actually get out of here. We need to get out of here. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Here, and now we need to enter into the blue area. Now, I got consistently lost trying to find this place. Follow my instructions and you'll be okay, for the most part. I can't really help you out too much. So we go all the way around, and then we go down here. Nope, that's a dead end, never mind. So then we go up here to the left. Actually, I can show you where we're going right here. Oh wait, no, yeah, we need to go down here, don't we? No, that's a dead end. What am I thinking? Okay, so no, that's not it. Okay, yeah. So yeah, let's go back down. And then past this humming. So yeah, then we go down and then up these stairs. Continue going left, now north. Yeah, we're going down through there. So we need to go up here and then down here. Nope, that's the wrong place. Okay. So then what do we need to go to? Okay. Okay, here, there it is. I think. I hope. I sure hope. Yeah, that's a dead end. So now we go down here. And to the left. Oh, here it is. Right here. Yeah, we were pretty close. Okay. So yeah, heal if needed. And now what we need to do is go all the way to the right. And we need to go up. And we got caught, of course. I think through the stairs? Nope. Okay. Go up. That's a dead end. Okay, so then we need to go down. Through these stairs. And then we go left, up, right. Okay. Yeah, that was a dead end. So then we need to go. Ah, here we go. Right here, right here. So, yeah, this is a little bit tricky. It's actually a lot harder than it looks. But basically, we need to break that pot with this pot. So, try to get yourself down here and just try to get as close as you can to breaking it. There we go. Now, the reason why we have to do that is because for some weird reason, we can't actually push this rock if that pot was in the way. So, we just need to push that rock to the side and push that up. And then we can step on the switch, which then unlocks that door. So now we need to get back to where we were. Oh yeah, if you feel that puzzle, you can actually just go through the steps and try again. If I turn that off? Anyway, and we can just go through the steps and then just try again. So. Anyway. Now we go through that steps, and we go up through these stairs, through those stairs. And then we go up here. And now a brown... Now a door from the brown thing came open, and we're done with this area. So now we need to go back to the brown room. So yeah, just backtrack your way back. Okay, so now we go back to the brown room. So, yeah, we just walk down. Yeah, down here. And then through this. No. We go up here. Yeah, that's right, because there's the humming runaway. Then we go up. Grass, so we need to go through. Yeah, we need to go around. Nope, not that way. I hate this place. Okay, yeah, now I remember. We go down, past the humming downward to the bridge. Oh, by the way, that onklet that we just lost to, that's actually a pretty good Denjuu. I would recommend getting one. Anyway, we're gonna have to get through two Penelopes here. See what I mean by the enemy placement here? It's not very great. Anyway, so yeah, talk to her if we need to heal. Now we go down this time. Oh, wow, I didn't encounter? Okay, yeah, but that works out. Okay, so now we go down here, and then to the left. Yeah, that's right. So then we go up to the right, and now we go down here, and we go up here. Now this puzzle is actually pretty easy. You just push this rock to the switch, and then you push this switch. Now the green room opens, and we're done with the brown room. So we can now exit. Yeah, that's right. We need to exit. That's what we need to do. So through here. Oh, by the way, I would actually recommend getting this item. It increases defense by 20, I believe. I think that's what it did. Okay, yeah, that guy's not letting it. There we go, we're now out of here. And now we're going to enter through the green room. So what we need to do in order to enter in there is from where we were, is go down to these bridges again. Dodge. Okay. Thank you. Now we go up, down. Didn't mean to do that. I meant to try to run. Okay. So, I think we still go past the humming. Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, I'm doing it right. Okay, so now we... Come on, move. Thank you. So we go up. Oh no, not this area. By the way, there's actually an exploit in this area. I actually uploaded it on my second channel. Basically, if you're to enter through this area or to the side of the other cliff, as you can see here, there's no Denjuu here, but if you're to go to a dead end and then go back, as you can see, there's actually a Denjuu. Same thing if you go through here, but for some reason, not the other entrances, like through here, so it's a little interesting tidbit there. Anyway, yeah, we need to go through here, and yes, this is Yeah, this is correct. So now we go down, and through here. Okay, so here we are at probably what stumped majority of people. Okay, so we... Seriously, that battle is unavoidable? Alright. I'm just gonna ignore it. Anyway. So yeah, we now go through those stairs, go up, all the way around to the steps, and then we press the switch, and I believe that's actually the final switch we need to press, I think. So if we go through these steps, yeah, that's gonna be unavoidable there. Okay. Then we go, okay, yeah, that's a dead end, but I'll take that pot. So if we can't go up, then we must go down. Through these stairs, and then we go further down. Nope, that's a dead end. So we go then. Oh, okay, right through there. Yeah, those doors were closed before, so. There we go. Dead end, apparently. To the right. Down the stairs. Go to a freaking dead end. So then we go left, maybe? Okay, yeah, this guy's not letting up. Oh, and it goes down. Are you serious? Okay. I don't think we go up there. So we go through these stairs. Almost there. Oh, we just went in a circle, didn't we? No. Okay, yeah, this is correct. Okay, awesome. Awesome, awesome. Save your game. Actually, no, not yet. Turn the animations back on. Okay. Yeah, turn the animations back on, and now save your game. Okay. Now, let's go to our contacts. Contact a strong Denjuu. If you don't have a strong Denjuu, then I would actually recommend that you pick up a Denjuu that knows the electric attacks, just like Tsugoli right here. Overall, though, I will go ahead and state that my team isn't actually as strong as the one in, well, my first save file. But that doesn't mean that all hope is all lost. Anyway, heal up if you need to. So anyway, the team I'm actually going to be using is my Penelio Skyform and Penelope Hillform, or Mountain Form, and of course Rex. Why these guys? Because these actually are the ones that I can actually instantly or call for one turn, so, and plus they just happen to be pretty much my strongest ones. Well, besides Hermit right here, but Hermit's actually kind of a bad matchup right now. So, anyway, let's go ahead and save. Save, heal up, do whatever you need to before you touch this chest. And there's actually... Ah, darn it, I didn't get to do it. If you were to... Yeah, in the last time I tried to do this guide, I actually jumped and Crypto actually stayed in midair. Or, so, that's not Crypto, what am I saying? Rex actually stayed in midair. I might show you that near the end. Anyway, so yes, here we are at the chest, and he's like wondering why Yu isn't here yet. He looks pretty exhausted, after all, you know. He doesn't have a guide like I do. Anyway, so Yu is actually kind of stopping our progress because he wants to see who is stronger. I'm like, really? And I believe Otome would probably say the same thing, even though she's not as brash as Yu. Otome, you know, still kind of really peeves Kyo, so yeah. Anyway, so yeah, here we go, we have, I think he's saying like, show me your strength, Kyo. Anyway, so let's look at his team. He has Dune, which is a lake reform. Actually, I think that could be a natural evolution. So yeah, we have a lake Denjuu, which is Dune. We have a Kukometsu. I think that's correct. Anyway, oh no, that is those little diacritics there. So it's like a Gigometsu, and then that's a sky reform. And then we have a Pamelio, which is a land reform. So take it as you will. I am going to be using, of course, my main crew, Penelope, and Pamelio, sky reform. So, yes, that is correct. Alright, so let's go ahead and do some damage to this guy. We're just gonna go ahead and go with a traditional slash attack because by the time our Denjuu arrive, it's probably gonna be healing if we use a Dema attack. So let's go ahead and just use a traditional attack. Not too much damage, but you know, it'll work for what we're trying to do. So now the entire crew is here. You will wait, or Otome. Oh, speaking of which, Otome actually has a different team than you. I can't remember it offhand, but Blaziken 257 actually does have, 275. Yeah, I think, no, it's 257. Okay, Blaziken 257 does actually have a video where he does fight Otome over here, and I will go ahead and leave a link in the description. So anyway, we're in pretty good shape right now, but I'll go ahead and heal up Rex's damage because that can help out. So anyway, this guy is gonna go next. I'm gonna attack my Pamelio. Oh no! Oh, hey, thank goodness. So, anyway, what we're going to be doing is actually getting rid of the Sky Reform first. The Sky Reform Denjuu first. Now, the reason we do this is because, well, once he has all three of his Denjuu, he won't hesitate. I'm not sure if Otome will do this as well, but he won't hesitate to do a triple combo where basically all three of his Denjuu attack one Denjuu. So, anyway, we don't have anything that's powerful against this Sky Reform here, or this Ground Reform, but we're just going to be attacking it anyway with this Bomb Rock. It should do neutral damage if I remember correctly, so. Oh, nope. That was actually a decent attack. Anyway, it's gonna use an herb pill. And we will do just the same on Penelope. A Oh, by the way, the names are a little bit messed up because I've been playing the English, or the quote-unquote fan translation. Okay, that's not gonna do much. But that will. Ooh, boy. They're really after Penelope. Okay. Let's end this one real fast. I know it seems ridiculous why I'm not attacking Dune, but it'll make sense sooner or later. And I got a crit, which is actually very, very nice. So anyway, let's go ahead and do some damage to Dune. Believe it or not, Dune is actually his weakest Denjuu in his team. So, yeah, that's a little bit interesting. Anyway, I know it won't do too much, but this is actually the most powerful attack that Penelope will produce right here. And Dune is down! We got lucky with that crit, too, or else that would have lasted another turn. Anyway, Rex leveled up. Nice going. And we got a spotlight for our reward there. Anyway, you or Otome will be saying, "Dret, I lost," and we'll race you to the end, and this time I will win. So, anyway, now with that done. Oh, so I had the silence off. So, when you turn it. Okay, so it's by default off, and then you can turn it on to turn on the silencer, I guess. Is that right? I guess so. Anyway, so yeah. Here we have the Antenna Tree Seed, and awesome. So if we're to walk out, now be careful with your selection before you just button mash. Now, if you were to press this button right here, you'll be staying in the cave, and you will be basically and you'll have to manually get out of here. It's okay if you want to search for more treasure, but if you're okay with doing it later, maybe, or even if you don't really care, you know, don't press this button if you want to get the treasure. That is if you don't want to get the treasure. Anyway, so yeah, if you're done with this cave, you're done with all the caves, really. Press the second button right here. So that, this will let you immediately escape. And then as soon as you exit, Kyle's wondering where you is because he was pretty much left first. It's like, ah, I win. What? What? What, I lost again? How could this be? I'll get you next time. Man, what is this deal? Anyway, so yeah, there's more talking, and here is Midori again. Oh, okay, so that Denjuu is actually back. So if we exit that cave, we can actually see the Denjuu. Okay, that's interesting. Anyway, there's some more talking, basically talking about how he got the antenna tree, and now we're walking back. And now it's very important that you do this, even though technically it's optional, but yeah, it's kind of important that you do this, because we don't want to go back and walk around in that labyrinth again. So heal up, buy some stuff if you need to, and then talk to the T-Finger. Wow, my accent just slid right there. Anyway, talk to the T-Finger. And they'll tell you to plant the antenna tree. The antenna tree seed. And now we're back here. Thank goodness they didn't have to force us to back travel, like I originally thought you originally had to do. And then go up to this antenna tree seed. There's more dialogue. You plant it right there. Alright. The antenna tree is full of life. We did it. And now, it's that strange Denjuu again. Every time you plant another tree, I regain some more of my strength. What do you suppose that was about? Heck if I know, but maybe... Mitsukiyo might know? I'll give him a call. Yeah, sure, blah blah blah. So yeah, they're gonna give Mitsukiyo a call. Anyway, Mitsukiyo answered the phone. Yes, Mitsukiyo here. Hi, it's Kyle. Or Kyo, I guess. I put Kyle there because I'm playing the bootleg translation. Anyway, Kyo, nice to see you again. Nice to hear you again. It's been a very long time, and I am freaking out. Why are you freaking out? Because there is something strange going on with... something like that, and I really don't know what's up here, but yeah, anyway, so yeah, there's gonna be a little bit more talk here, and we actually get another melody. So anyway, yeah, there's more talk, and now we're back into the village that we were with that T-finger right there. But anyway, so we got ourselves another melody. Oh wait, no, I don't think it was this kind of thing. Okay, I think it was this one's the, yeah, it's right here. So we got this one. Anyway, so yeah, now go ahead and save your game, again, and now rest, yep, rest. You've been through a lot, you really have. You haven't been through the same pain that I have, but take a break. You don't want to continue playing right now, as much to you as you want to. I would just recommend that you just save, turn off the game, sit back, take a deep breath, put your hands on top of your head, and just say, I did good today. You deserve it, because even though you haven't been through the hell, you still went through hell. Yeah, you haven't been through the hell I've been through, but you still went through hell. So anyway, with that being out of the way, that was pretty much the hardest dungeon, for me at least, according to the guide that I use, that said that it's the second hardest dungeon, but I'll let future decide whether I do another guide or not. Anyway, so that's it, I'll be seeing ya, have a nice day, you did good. Hey guys, before I shut out the glitch, I just want to go ahead and give a quick shout out to Zelard. He's the guy that made the guide to Telefang 2. He's from Game FAQs, and I'll leave the guide in the description as well. I didn't give him enough credit. Zelard is the man, really. I mean, without him, there wouldn't really be this guide, or really, I doubt anyone would really beat Telefang 2. Really, thank you, Zelard, for making that GameFAQs guide, and it helped me out, and I apologize for saying that it's poorly detailed, but, so, yeah, but, anyway, without your help, this guide wouldn't be possible. So anyway, on to the glitch. Heal if needed. So, here we go. Wow, that's an interesting glitch. So, here we go. Wow, that's an interesting glitch. Okay, so... Here comes you or Otome if you're playing speed. So anyway, they want to do a battle here.